Toastmasters, and yes, my name is Annika San Luis, and since finals are coming in real close, I decided that I'll talk about stress management. So before we go into stress management, first we must know what stress is. So what is stress? Stress is the body's response to a threat or a demand. For example, if you were hiking in the woods to enjoy the beauty of nature and you saw a bear, and the bear wasn't too happy to see you, your brain is going to detect that you're in danger and release chemicals into your bloodstreams that will give you the energy and the strength to go through that situation. So your body may have three responses to that. One, you can try to fight the bear. Good luck with that. Second, you can try and run as fast as you can from the bear. Or there's a third option, you can just freeze and hope that the bear doesn't know that you're there. So two out of three are very essential to your survival. And that's part of your fight and flight response. So overall, stress is very essential to your survival. But what if you're overly stressed? You have too much. Then stress can be very harmful to you. Stress can impact you in four different ways. It can affect you physically by causing aches and pains in your body. You can have a headache, neck pain, back pain, digestive issues, and it can also affect your immune system. So when you feel too stressed out, you feel sick and fatigued. And if you already have a condition or if you're already sick and you're stressed, then it can actually make the conditions worse. Stress can also affect you behaviorally. Whenever you feel stressed, you may be prone to eat less or more than how you usually would. You might also develop bad habits such as smoking and drinking. Stress can affect you emotionally. You can have mood swings. Maybe you'll be happy one second and angry the other. You'd be more prone to getting angry for the smallest of things. And it can affect you cognitively. So we call this stress stupid, because when you're too stressed out, you start forgetting things like, oh, I have a meeting. Did I have a meeting today? What was due today? And so on. So these are the different ways that stress can impact you. What can you do? Well, one of the things you can do to overcome stress is to exercise, everyone's favorite activity. Now, even though you might be thinking that I'm already feeling stressed out, why would I want to exercise for? Exercise is really good, one of the best ways to handle stress, because when you exercise, it releases a feel-good hormone called endorphin. And when endorphin is in the body, it makes you feel more positive and it also like reduces your perception of pain. And you can do different types. You don't have to be an athlete or go to the gym all the time to exercise. You can like try to incorporate it into your schedule, like go to the grocery store, just walk around, park a bit further, so you can just put a more distance into it. Or you can also try to take the stairs instead of taking the elevator and escalator. And another way you can do it is try to practice meditation. Meditation is also a good way to help reduce stress. But what if I don't have time for exercise and all of this? Then I would tell you, you have to learn how to manage your time. So that's the second way, the other way to overcome stress. Try to manage your time. One, don't try to overcommit. If you already have too much on your plate, don't try to add more. Learn to say no. Don't accept the extra task if you're not able to do so. Try to prioritize your work. If you have like an essay due in 3 days and an exam in a week, try to get that essay out the way so then you can use the rest of the time for the exam. Try to break projects into smaller pieces. There's a quote where it's like, to eat an elephant, you have to try to eat it in bite-sized pieces. If you're thinking, why would I eat an elephant? That's weird. You should probably go back and try to catch the point I'm making about breaking into smaller pieces. Or if you're capable, delegate the task. Try to divide it. Have friends help you out with the task ahead. And go on to the next court, get support. Now, if you feel too stressed out, it's always good to go to a family or friend. They may not be able to fix your problem per se, but it's always nice to have someone to just listen to. Now, if you feel like you're being a burden and don't want to give them, share, If you don't want to be a burden onto your family, then you can always just go see counseling. I mean, FIU has a good counseling support right here because they can help, as my shirt says. And not only can you like receive support, you can try to give support. You feel give support. Usually people feel really good about helping others and volunteering and things like that. So those are the three different ways that stress can help you. You can try to exercise, you can manage your time better, or you can just get support. Thank you very much.